Hello. In this video I show you how to deploy Windows 11 over the network without a domain controller. Let's get started. This is the server I used in this case. First I installed the OS deployment service. This is used to customize the installer. We usually use it in a certain domain. But in this case I deployed it in a group. To do that, you install the following tools. These are the tools to customize the OS image file. These tools help you add or remove components in the installer. For example, you can add an application to the installer. So after finishing, your computer has the software you want without having to do it manually. I recommend you install the older version, because I tried the newer version and got some unexpected errors. So you should use the version like I am installing. Next, you install the deployment toolkit. You download the installer that is suitable for your operating system using. After completing the installation of the tools on the server, you follow these steps. You open the deployment tool and create a new shared folder. I create a new shared folder by default. You can change the storage location if you want. In this folder, there will be subfolders with different purposes. We should start from the basic and most used steps. That is deploying the operating system over the network. First, you add the operating system to this tool. On the computer, you mount the installer downloaded from the home page to access the files. Next, you browse to the source folder to add. You name the folder to match the operating system you just added. Here is a list of versions and you can choose one of them to install on the target computer. I create a new task. I will choose one of the versions listed above to install on the client. You set up the identifier, name. Then set up the organization, password if you want. Above is basic steps to deploy, but you should add the following steps to create a complete and error-free installation. While installing the operating system, you often encounter some questions and I want to skip them. So I customize as above to skip them. You can skip this step if you want to install manually. Next, you add a scripts file. The purpose of this scripts file is to fix the error. You add it to a folder named scripts in the shared folder. Then you customize the task created in the previous step. This error does not occur when you deploy on a virtual machine and occurs when deploying on a physical computer. You customize the task and change the order as above. After completing the above configurations, you create a new boot file as follows. You follow the steps above to create a file that helps you boot over the network. Now I add the newly created file to the operating system deployment system. You configure the server. You use a standalone server deployment. Thus, the client computers connect to the server via local network and install the operating system. You add the boot file created in the previous step. I browse to the folder where the boot file is stored and add it to the system. Next, I customize the boot so that the client boots over the network more easily. I recommend that you restart the system after completion to ensure the changes are applied. Completed the system building steps and come to the deployment steps on the client. I connect the client to the server over the network. I use a router to allocate IP addresses. If you are not using a router, your server needs to install an IP address allocation server. On the client, I set up the computer to boot over the network. The client has successfully connected to the server. You are asked to enter the administrator account on the server to install the operating system. You just select the task from the list and follow the steps as above. Later in this video, I will guide you to add applications to the default installation. After restarting the computer, make sure it is booted from hard drive. Next, you don't have to do anything but wait. And here is my result. Very convenient, right? You can deploy to multiple client computers at the same time. As mentioned, I will add applications to the default installer. I will download the installer of a software and add it to the deployment system. In the list of folders, there is a folder for adding applications. In this folder, you create a new subfolder to add the unzipped application. You follow these steps to add a new application. After completing, you update the configuration. Now you will have a new boot file. So I will delete the old boot file and replace it with the new one. The new file has been replaced successfully. Like last time, I will deploy on the client. Pause here for a moment. Different from last time, this time a screen appears with a list of applications for you to choose from. From this list, you choose the applications you want to install on the client. So you don't have to install the application manually. Here are the basic steps to deploy an operating system over the network. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.